To help you understand how to write cold emails so good that are impossible to ignore, I analyzed 100 emails I received, and I will share with you what I found. By the way, they really surprised me. By the end of the video, I will also review the email that got my first UX design client. I'm Aliena, I teach design at Fast Track UX. These are the 100 emails I analyzed, and I grouped them into three categories: archive, reply later, and reply now. If an archive an email, it means there's no reply, unless the sender follows up with something compelling. If I choose to reply later, I'm not excited, or I'm just not ready at that moment, and there's a chance I'll forget about it. The green category is reply now. These emails make me want to take immediate action, and we all want our emails to land into this category. Let's discover how to do that. My original guess was that there's a certain way to write an email so professional that will make people want to reply immediately. But that is not what the results show. The results show that the emails I archive versus those I respond to come from very different content categories. I receive so many sponsorship emails and emails from video editors, so when I see a similar email, I tend to archive it immediately. I also receive many emails from UX designers who want to work at my company. I've been through this career phase when I was looking for a job, and I really want to respect everyone who offered their time. However, if there's no opening at my company, these emails tend to end up in reply later category. On the other hand, since my full-time effort is focusing on teaching at Fast Track UX, my course platform, I'm much more likely to reply to emails about my course. Almost all course-related emails end up in the green category, regardless how professional it is written. So, my friend, first make the content of your email something the receiver cares about. Content beats perfect writing. Even though I found that professionalism is not as important as the content, it still matters a lot, especially in crowded spaces. In other words, when money is involved, people are cautious. I think it makes sense. If someone cannot write a professional email, then I won't expect high for our future communication. Here are a few tips to write more professionally. I will demonstrate by comparing two sponsorship emails I got. One I archived immediately, and the other I replied right away. I suggest including a professional profile picture because it really helps to visualize who I'm communicating with. Gmail usually assigns a letter or an ugly gray icon, which gives the impression of talking to a robot. When starting an email, address the receiver by name. Use a generic hello. When a name is not included, it feels like the email is just a template. And I can tell you there's so many spam emails out there that just start with hello. And personally, I don't like reading an email starting with, "I hope this message finds you well." I know it's a really common opening, but if you're somebody who needs to read hundreds of emails a day, then you already wanted to get to the message faster. Also, ChatGPT almost always start an email with this sentence, so a lot of emails with this opening gives off a very AI tone. So I suggest you to just get to the point quicker. And if you really want to start with a greeting, maybe include something more personal. How about something like, "First, I want to congratulate on your engagement." If you're an aspiring designer, then there's no better time to enroll in the Google UX Design Certificate by Coursera. They've just released a section on using AI in UX design. If you enroll today, you will get immediate access. I went through these AI updates already, and the content they teach is exactly how I'm using generative AI every day as a UX designer, from improving stakeholder communication to making design decisions and writing great portfolio copy. I completed this certificate when I first started my UX journey because I wanted something self-paced, affordable, and backed up by a top tech company. I love that the course is broken into bite-sized lessons, the videos are shot right in Google's offices, and it really helped me understand the UX design process. I also like that enrolling in Coursera Plus unlocks not just the Google UX certificates, but also tons of other amazing courses from partners like Meta, Microsoft, IBM. These are the certificates I've completed on Coursera, and the knowledge I gain has come in handy in unexpected ways. My next goal is probably going to be taking the new Google AI certificates. Let me know if you want a review video on that. Drop a comment. Coursera helped me make lifelong learning a habit. And after all these series of making content about Coursera, I want to thank them for sponsoring this video. And I hope for many more to come. Links to Coursera Plus is in the description. And please use the default Sans-Serif font when drafting an email. This might just be a personal experience, but most emails I receive with serious font, the content literally feels like it's copied from a Word document. Next, if you want to offer your service to someone, I also suggest including a custom signature. This allows the receiver to quickly check your social profiles. I especially like to check someone's LinkedIn. Here's a custom signature I really like. And this person even includes a cool illustration of themselves. I love it. Another thing I found is that when someone puts in real effort, like having a little video, I just have to watch and see what you come up with. And doing basic research on the recipient is also a must. And if you're offering your work, if you can deliver something right away, it'd be even better. Here's a bad example. This person offered to create a masterclass for me, but I already have a course. And I don't have the best example for this point, so this is the closest I could find. This person included a long video, which is really good, but I still chose to reply later because it just happened to be another person offering video editing service. And also it just happened to be commenting on a video that I deliberately chose a minimal editing style. But imagining doing this for a UX design job. Record a long video, going through your potential client's product, and give them some comments. That could really help. If the purpose of your email is not to offer your service, but rather to ask a few questions, then I think it's a little bit more easier. All you need to do is show the person that you know them, you've watched their content, you've read their papers, you've saw their work. For example, someone once shared how they discovered my channel, they mentioned what they remembered from it, and asked for a link to my old portfolio. And I happily replied right away. Another thing I found is that if this email referred to something that I'm passionate about, then I'll be replying right away regardless of your professionalism. For example, this person asked me about relocating to Canada and US, and this just happened to summarize what I experienced in my past. And even though the format is not the best, I replied right away. And for the next finding, this one is very important if you want to offer your service or find a job. So, don't tell. I've received so many emails claiming great success, but without any links, any case studies, any supporting document. If you say you help someone to design a website, they include a link of that website or include your portfolio or your case study. Your work speaks for itself. Here's a bad example. This person helps design-focused YouTuber to monetize audience, but there's no case study, no link, and no success story. And here's a good example. This person included a clear case study of how she helped a similar YouTuber, and I actually worked with her for a trial round. The actual case study is longer than this screenshot, by the way. Imagine doing this for a UX design client. This will even save this person the time to go to another link. And I'm sure some of you would ask, but what if I have no success story? Well, in that case, try to offer a free trial period. The next few points don't really apply for the purpose of cold outreach to getting a job, but they will still help a lot to build great professional relationship. If you want to ask someone questions, I strongly suggest you to just ask one question. Here's an example of what I grouped to reply later. There are just way too many questions here. However, I really want to give this person an applause for sending this email, because this person is still in high school, and she's brave enough to send an email to ask for professional advice. If you send the email, you are already the winner, because most people don't have the gut to send an email to who they look up to. On the other hand, this is an email that I replied to right away. The story really speaks to me and the question is pretty specific. I've also realized that if someone mentioned that we've met before, then I will just directly reply. It's very interesting. I don't know why, but for some reason, I feel like if we met before, then we're no longer a stranger and I will treat you as like a friend. This just shows how important it is to build genuine human connections over time. And out of 100 emails I received and analyzed, there are two that are so interesting and special. And all these two emails did was just sending good vibes. And they really lightened my day. Here's one example. If there's someone you really hope to connect with, but you don't know what question to ask or what to say, perhaps just send an appreciation letter. So after analyzing 100 emails, I realized that the key to sending an email so good that's impossible to be ignored is just to focus on the content and make it something that the receiver cares about. We also don't really exactly know what the receiver would care about. So the takeaway is simple. Don't overthink it. Just send the damn email. There have been so many times in my life where I overthought about how to send an email so good, so professional, in order to get a response from someone that I look up to. But because I was overthinking, I was procrastinating, I didn't even try. I cannot imagine how many opportunities I'd missed out because I was too perfectionist or shy. Meanwhile, there are so many people out there having way sketchier skill set, but they get better opportunities because they had the courage to send out that email. And literally, the worst thing that can happen is you don't get a reply. And of course, professionalism still helps, and I've shared a lot of tips on that. You can save this video, watch it later again. Finally, here's the email I promised to review. It has been a very long time since I wrote this email. I am so proud of what we have achieved. Honestly, many of the amazing opportunities that happened to me, it happened because I just wanted to try if I can connect to someone by sending a quick outreach email. If you like this video, you will also like this video. I'm Aliena, and the link to Coursera Plus is in the description. If you want to read more of my exclusive content, then you shall also subscribe to my email list, Trading's Topic. Thank you so much, guys. Cheers.